ended up here?
We're going to go look around the Whitgift Centre, which is a down shopping centre in South London, because Westfield are going to build a new Westfield in Croydon.
At this point, I'm going to start using the microphone, because even the shopping centre is completely quiet at this bit, anyway. Kids screaming ruin the video, and it's really annoying. So, I'm zooming into the signage here, because as you can see, second from the bottom, Aldi's Square. Aldi's, really. Now, that was a massive department store chain in the UK, which went bust years ago. And the fact that it's still up there, and they still call it Aldi's Square, really shows you how they've struggled to fill it, which is really bad. That is the Entertainer, which is a toy shop, one of the biggest toy store chains in the UK. And they're going to knock this shopping centre down to build Westfield eventually. Now, if you watch Dan Bell or Retail Archaeology, you'll know that this is quite a feature what they do in shopping centres, and that's turn water fountains into plant pots. And they've really ruined it. That looks like a gorgeous fountain back in its day. And they've ruined it by filling it in. That is the escalator where you can see the workings of it, which I don't think you see enough of. I'm quite blokey in that sort of thing, you know. I like to see mechanical things working like that. No, the shopping centre's quite clean and tidy, which is really nice. Well, if you forget the fact that someone's ditched the gin and tonic in the new plant pot there, the former fountain. Yeah, I love working mechanics like this. We should see more of this. I love that. And I'll get closer in a minute so you can see. There you go. Yeah, we should definitely see more of that. You see that nowhere, really. You see the reflection there as well, but the roof of the shopping centre is all glass. It's really bright. It's lovely. This gallery was quite dull. There was nobody in there, and I couldn't even see a member of staff. And a lot of the shops in here are empty. I'd say that the shopping centre is 50% empty. The stores are closed. But still very clean and tidy. Most of the lights were working, but only half working, because there's several bulbs in the light fittings. I'll cover this more. But it does lead to this really strange effect of it. Oh, that was a security guard trying to make sure they don't see me. But those light fixings, they've got about two bulbs in each one. Most of them was half broken. You will see a thumb in the side of this video for quite a bit, but it does go away. Shops like this, though, I do love. I love aquariums and I love fish. So look at these gorgeous aquariums and fish tanks they were selling in there. At first, I thought it was some sort of museum, but it's not. They actually do sell aquariums and fish. And I miss keeping fish because they're so relaxing to watch. You know, before the days of YouTube, you probably sat and looked at an aquarium. Look at the shabumpkins. Look, it thinks I'm going to feed it. I love them. And then in this tank, it was loads of fantail ones, but they've got a couple of blackmores in there. I love blackmore fish. Look at them, they're so black. Love them. I would love to have a tank full of them. I felt sorry for the bloke who was working there, though, because just then he stood up because he thought he was going to make a sale. Bless him. I felt a bit sad for not buying anything, but I can't go all the way from Croydon Whitgift Shopping Centre all the way back to Shepherd's Bush. So my thumb gets a bit worse here, but it will go away, I promise you. I didn't realise I was doing this. Normally I film on my normal camera, but I was using my phone that I've not used for ages. It's a really rubbish Microsoft phone. But it was better for stealth filming like this. That's a cleaner. There was quite a few cleaners in the shopping centre. And he is actually working. I don't want to get him into trouble. I'm glad we didn't see his face because I don't want to get him the sack. The shopping centre was clean. It was immaculate. That is the Waterstones, which is a massive bookshop store chain in the UK. Now, this was quite a common theme. It was quite often a lie. There can't possibly be a door problem in a shopping centre. But so many of the shops had closed, sealed off doors just so they could restrict access into the shops to areas that were busier, but were actually really irritating. I just wanted to go in. And so many shops had locked, look, Superdry. That is actually an open shop. But it looks closed, but it is open. All the major retailers are in this shopping centre. They really are. People were slagging off Croydon to me, and they were saying that this Whitgift shopping centre is terrible. Do you know what? It really isn't. The problem is, in the years this shopping centre has been open, in the last 20 years, they've been threatening to knock it down and turn it into a Westfield. Right now, Hammerson is running this shopping centre for Westfield. You know, continuing to maintain it and clean it and whatever. Until the owners of Westfield eventually decide to knock it down and build a new shopping centre. But there's me, suddenly realising I've got the light on my camera. I'm such an idiot. So what's happened is, a lot of retailers have just simply not moved into this shopping centre. So it's... And the shops that are in there have not invested in any of their refreshes or anything, so they look really dated and old. Another thing that's happened in 20 years is the internet. Internet shopping has just exploded. And there's been mergers, and shops have closed down and gone out of business. I mean, there's only one record shop in the UK now that's national, and that's HMV. Whereas 20 years ago, there was probably about five. You had Our Price, you had Virgin, you had Andy's Records, you had them all. But you don't have any of that now. Who is going to fill any of these units now? Nobody. If there was to build the Westfield, who would move in? Significantly fewer people. This is more images of the dodgy lighting. I think these particular lights were flickery because they've changed them to LED bulbs to save on a bit of cash. As you can see, lovely glass atrium ceilings. We're now coming up to the Alders Square. This is where the old department store used to be. Now, Alders originated from Croydon. This was their main shop. So if that was still Alders today, you'd have gone into a really old building, a shopping centre. They built the shopping centre onto the side of Alders because that's how big it was. There's loads of these shops, and quite a lot of them had really naff names like Fashion Zone and stuff. You know the type of shops where everything's under a fiver, everything's under a tenner, and you still feel like you're getting ripped off? It's usually women's clothes and accessories. So this is the old Alders store. I didn't go in there. There was an amusement arcade, which is another stalwart of a dying shopping centre. If you watch Dan Bell or Retail Archaeology, you'll know that. And it was just filled with general tat, and they've called it Outlet Village. Really naff. And wait till you see the outside, it's terrible. That's a Costa. Costa is the world's second biggest coffee chain after Starbucks. And Coca-Cola have just bought it. I'm not too bothered about that, actually. I think Coca-Cola and Costa sounds like a natural good blend of a shopping coffee shop, rather. The shopping centre roof, look. This, I believe, is a refreshed one. Because when it first opened in the early 1960s, this shopping centre did not have a roof. It did open in stages up until the 1970s. It didn't all open at once. WH Smith there is a really overpriced book stationery sort of dump, really. I really hate WH Smith. I really do. I am going to actually go in there because so many of these stores have not been invested in for such a long time. It's like walking back into the past. Because why would you refresh or refit a shop that's going to be at risk of getting demolished? You wouldn't do it, would you? And since this has been rumbling on for the last 20 years, you get a really good old feel of it. That Clark's shoe shop is over two floors massive. But all the big retailers are still in here. Look, JD Sports, Topshop. There's a PC Well, Curry's, Dixon's, whatever that to call it. Superdry, River Island, New Look. They are all in here. The problem is not that shops are moving out as such, it's just that because they've gone bust. So many women now buy the clothes online that they don't go out into the shopping centres anymore. I think if they just decided to keep the shopping centre going as it is, more retailers, proper retailers, would move in, and there you go, and it'd be less of these sort of shops. Everything £5 and under. I hate them shops so much. The floors were really nice and clean and tidy, and litter bins were empty, you know, everything was being kept in good shape. The area of Croydon I don't think is going to benefit much from a Westfield in it. I did actually talk to some of the shopkeepers and other people who worked in the shopping centre as well, and it's just going to make it, all they're going to do is have the same shops that are in here now. And then they're going to move in a few posh shops.
This Virgin Media store is looking a bit sad. Look how dirty it is. It's like all like dust covered junk. And as you can hear, they've left the alarms on, all the systems. They're all flashing away and beeping. They've left it all switched on still. Now there is another shopping centre called the Central. I think that's leached onto this. So
Let's have a look at
this
that.
This is an old WH Smith logo. You won't see that anywhere on any shop after the... I think it was 1994 they changed the logo, so that shows you how old it is. And yet another closed door, just blocked off with stock. And inside this WH Smith, which I hated being in, but if you look up at the ceiling there's a really old lift and stairs sound, which is so 80s. Shopping centres are not a really big thing as they are in America. In the UK, we generally have high streets that have been pedestrianised, which is a thing that I'm not really for either, because it stops traffic and accessibility of customers getting in, and it forces people to having to park in expensive car parks. Now, this shopping centre was quite full because it's got a car park in it. I should have seen how much it was to park there, but it must have been popular because it was quite busy on the way to the car parking area. I'm actually rushing out here. This has been slowed down, not because I'm being pushed out by a security guard. It's just that I wanted to get out of WH Smith. Yeah. There's a BB's there, and that closed down ages ago.
Mid-2000s, I think, they went into administration. These are an HMV open, and it's got an outside, inside store unit. So that's good. So that means if the shopping centre was ever closed down, they could keep that HMV open until they finally flatten it. But the Whitgift Shopping Centre, look at it. It's bright, it's clean, it's tardy. It's a real shame that it's just been on the card so long to be knocked down, but retailers have been scared to open up in there, really. There's that closed down Virgin Media store with left all the alarms on. I'm walking now to a lift, which was in good working order. No squeaks or creaks or anything. But you're going to get a bit of a taste of the agingness of it when it opens. I was a bit worried to get in at first since I knew that they were shutting the shopping centre down. You can see it already, but look at that carpet up the walls! And it looks so 80s. Look at that blue and red spots. Maybe early 90s, but yeah. That was an overload button I'm pointing to, which made me laugh because it's, you know, I was expecting it to go off of just me being in there. Now it says that 16 pairs can fit in there, which is a funny abbreviation of persons. And I was thinking, well, maybe back in the 80s and 90s, but you know where the B-City is the way it is this day. And I'm no feather. I don't think you could ever fit 16 people in there. This old telephone as well, the old telephone sign. 50p to make a phone call. 50p. Ridiculous, isn't it? Gosh. What's got 50p? And would you even know the phone number to ring anybody on? Now we're coming up to Poundland, which is a rather ubiquitous, you know, pound shop, really. Things cost more than a pound now. And it's still got the old signage up saying everything's a pound, which is a lie. Because things in there now cost £2, £3, £5, whatever. This is Mothercare, which is always on the brink of administration. It's got an early learning sign in the window because they bought that ages ago. It's got the old Mothercare shop signage on, obviously. I couldn't see anybody in there, which is bad. It's really in one of the deadest corners of this dead, dying shopping mall. It was his shopping mall more in the UK rather than shopping mall. And actually, that's a bit of a lie as well, because we'd actually say shopping centre. We don't say the word mall very much. A couple of shopping centres use the word mall. They'll say upper mall, lower mall. And then there is the mall, who used to own a load of shopping centres. I think there's still a thing, but yeah. We don't say shopping mall. Warren James has moved outside, so even though it's closed down in a shopping centre, it still is actually open for business, but just on the high street. This is quite a strange thing, actually, because when shops usually close down, they usually take all the shop signage down and pretend there was never there at all. But as you saw in the Virgin Media bit, not only just leaving all the shop signage up, they're just leaving it general mess, which is not very nice. This is mirrors, which were spotless. Hello, that was me. And outside, this is the old Alders department store. As you can see, very old. And the shopping centre was built around it, really. Now, behind them awful shop frontages, I bet there's the old lovely Alders sign. Alders sign, rather. I keep saying Alders like Aldi. But there's awful shops that are in there now. It really is sad. And look at the state of it. That is on the high street. It looks awful. That's the HMV. Which is strange to be still open, actually. They went bust. and then Hilco bought them, which is a turnaround company, and seems to have done pretty well. This is the other shopping centre, which is also run by Hammerson on behalf of Westfield, I do believe. Not too sure about that bit of information. Oh my word, they were so funny about me filming. Now, outside, bearing in mind, I am on the high street here, and I'm just having a bit of a sneaky look for the blatantly closed down Pound World, which was run into the ground by the awful management. They blamed everybody else, but it was actually just bad management. And I'm just outside here. I'm actually using my normal camera here, and I was just saying that when Mike Ashley bought House of Fraser, I hope he does not buy Debenhams, because he's not going to keep both of them open. These are two massive department store chains in the UK, and House of Fraser's just been recently put out of admin. And right about here, a security guard comes up to me and says, "Why are you filming?" I said, "Somebody go at me." Well, not a go at me, but he didn't like you filming. This bit, what I'm doing, I've got my phone out again and pretending to take selfies. So ignore me clowning around. Ignore my ugly mug and look around my head. This is the Central Shopping Centre. It was a bit busier, but the point of this shopping centre now, it's been used by Hammerson to keep the land, to keep the other shop businesses happy. They're going to move the companies out of Whitgift Shopping Centre into this shopping centre whilst Westfield's getting built back. As you can see, there's quite a few empty shops in here. Compensation has not been sorted out or anything yet. But oh my word, the security guard must have radioed all the other security guards to warn them that he'd seen me outside in the street filming. Because oh my word, that is something that people do not do in the 21st century right now. It's almost as if they've never heard of YouTube, and they've never heard of selfies or phones or cameras, and they didn't like anything being filmed at all. So I got the hell out of there, and I went back to Whitgift Shopping Centre. Now this is the way to the car park, well, from the car park. Look at this gorgeous old floor! And apart from a few cracks, it was perfectly shiny. Look at that gorgeous old floor. These vending machines made me chuckle. That is a Pepsi machine. That is a Coke machine. For the first time, people, we are seeing a marriage of Coca-Cola and Pepsi. They eloped and got married and they are living together happily in the Whitgift Shopping Centre in Croydon. There we go. We now go over to the old floor again, and this awful black lamp that must have been added in one of the refreshes of the shopping centre in the 90s. And it looks awful. From a distance, it looks like a swastika. It's awful. That's one of them shops filled with interest-free credit on furniture that'll probably fall to bits after a couple of weeks. This is Boots, which was the first shop to open in the Whitgift Shopping Centre in the 60s. And Boots is a huge chemist chain in the UK. It's owned by Walgreens, the American company Walgreens now. But that Boots is huge. It really is quite a big Boots. Not the biggest one I've seen. The one in the Arndale Shopping Centre in Manchester is bigger. Now, in Sainsbury's Square, one of the furniture shops, I've seen it as a good idea to put sofas, settees, couches, whatever you like to call them, in the middle of the square, which I hate. Because that means kids walking around, swinging the drinks around and whatnot, like you just saw. It's going to get them settees completely destroyed. I've never been a fan of that. More of them awful black towels on the floor there. It makes it look as if the floor's been damaged and they've just repaired it with them black towels because they couldn't find a good match. But no, them black towels are on purpose. It's awful, isn't it? You just saw River Island there. I'm doing a quick turn there because I saw two security guards, so I went into Sainsbury's there. But all the major retailers are in here. They really are. You've got your River Island, you've got your Currys PC World, you've got your Super Dry, you've got Waterstones. This H. Samuel clearly has not had a refit since the 90s. Look at that faded carpet. It's gone like a salmon pink.
The signage has not been used since the mid-90s. Now, the front one was broken, but the two on the side were still working with the red neon. More bums there.
And this is the older part of the shopping centre again. And it looks so cute. I love it. Now, to the right of the screen there, you'll actually see a fitness shop. Now, that is actually a GNC. I think they've called it a different name now in the UK. But if you watch Retail Archaeology and Dan Bell, GNC is a stalwart of dead shopping centre leasing. They must be on a good rent. Like most of the shops in here, they must be on a good rent. Because they must be on a rolling, maybe biannually good rent to stay open. Because for the last 20 years, every 2 years they've been saying they're going to shut it down and build a new Westfield. That's stepping from the new to the old there. The Works is a great shop. I love it. Like, really cheap books and stationery and whatnot. But this makes me laugh. When a shop closes down and they immediately open right next door. Why do they do that? I mean, all right, yeah, probably the leases and whatnot, but it makes me laugh. I think what the Works should have done here, since they've got so much art stuff, is made a sign saying, we've closed down, but don't worry, we've opened right next door. I'm coming to the end of the video, so now, thanks for watching. Please scratch that in the comment section down below. Oh, that was the clock that said 10 past 12. It was working, but it was either massively slow or massively fast. Can't tell. Toy barn house there, which I'd never heard of before, but it's another toy shop. So yeah, thanks for watching. Please scratch that in the comment section down below if you liked watching this video, and if you want to see more dead shopping centres in the UK, because we don't have many shopping malls that are dying, really. Yeah. Thanks for watching. Bye. That was the Whitgift Shopping Centre in Croydon.